Shane Jones.
Mr. Speaker, it's very important when a world event comes to Aotearoa that all dimensions of our Aotearoa identity are put on show. And so, sir, I've no doubt in my mind the current Minister of Māori Affairs, a very important figure in Te Ao Māori, means well when he seeks to project the identity of the people that he has, if not a literal, then a figurative responsibility for through the political process. But, sir, as much as it pains us to be accused of making a mockery of a small hapu in Ngāti Whātua, the notion, sir, that a plastic waka, a tapa waka, is a suitable vessel to reflect the aspirations, the dreams of day-to-day Māori families living in Auckland throughout New Zealand cannot go unchallenged. Now, sir, it may come to pass that the notion of a tapa waka is a Walt Disney creation. And as I've listened, sir, to Goofy over there and Mickey Mouse straight out of Disneyland, we have learned to tolerate, sir. We have learned to tolerate those contributions. No, sir, I won't debate who the National Party believes is Goofy or Mickey Mouse. They'll make that decision when they make their list up. And I can tell you what, sir, a few of those people on that list, they're going to be on the plastic fantastic out of this joint because they no longer have a future amongst that particular waka. But, sir, I need to come back to what's really serious about this debate. Māori unemployment is out of control. Māori achievement in terms of our young men and our young women in Tāmaki Makaurau worsens by the year. The sense, sir, of hopelessness, depression amongst ordinary families as they struggle to pay their bills actually, sir, deteriorates. And what do we hear as to how those people might be uplifted through the World Cup experience? We hear that $2 million is going to be used to make a tapa waka, and then, sir, it's likely to be dismantled or destroyed after it's been used for 17 days. Well, sir, I know that the former Minister of Māori Affairs and his friends can't actually divide 17 into 2 million, but it adds up, sir, to a substantial amount of money each day for pitifully low return and nothing, sir, to do with what the young people want to show on behalf of their country. And so what about the thousands of artisans, the thousands of people doing voluntary work or lowly paid work in art and culture and recreation, entertainment? Not a sliver of opportunity, sir, was given to them to participate in a non-contestable process. No, they're going to be, sir, served up this garish image as if somehow all we can develop for Aotearoa to project ourselves to the rest of the world and introduce some indigeneity into that projection is a plastic, ill-conceived, hastily executed waka. And, sir, it actually diminishes the concept of waka. In the north, we have the true tohunga, sir, who has revived waka, Hector Busby. And was he given the opportunity? Were they given the opportunity to participate? Where you could actually have something, sir, that reflected authenticity. Now, sir, I realise that upon hearing the word authenticity, that man breaks out in boils. Now, sir, those boils are in a very, very large mouth. Now, sir, it's not my problem that they don't care about authenticity in identity. They belong to the National Party, and yet they try to pretend they're Māori. So that is a deep DNA-based problem they've got anyhow. No, sir, it is a reasonable criticism to make at a time where thousands of garden variety Māori families are struggling. All they can hear from the Minister of Māori Affairs is a plastic waka and a Clayton seabed in foreshore. And in addition to that, if while they haven't got enough kai on their table in the Tāmaki Makaurau, they can look at the Harbour Bridge one day per year and see a flag fluttering. So these are trinkets. These are empty symbols, sir. These aren't the sentiments or the finer qualities that New Zealanders should be proudly projecting the rest of the world. And only Jose Gia and Petey Wepu being in the All Blacks will show that there's Māori pride in the World Cup. Kia ora tātou.
The Honourable Tohenare.